Well, I guess we're really left with no choice then, except to try the elevator one more time, and nah, it's not gonna work, is it? Well, shit. I guess we're moving forward. You may have noticed this glowing green fire hydrant, which would indicate to me that it's heavily irradiated. Or maybe the game just really wants me to shoot them. Because that will... it's supposed to put out the fire. Except it doesn't. And that guy still managed to burn to death. Hydrant was 2 feet away, idiot. You're dumb. Well, I'm dumb. I just walked right into it. Okay. Shoot what? I don't know what you're talking about. Are you talking about, like, oh. Oh, you mean that griffin. Well, that was easy. Miraculously, luckily enough, that somehow manages to dislodge that sofa that was oh so inconveniently halting our progress. Here we have our first grenade weapon. Here we have our first primary weapon, the SMG. This game's moving along at this rapid-fire pace. And yeah, the cops are of no help in this game. Your AI buddies, not much to them. They exist basically just to die in front of you so you can pick up their ammo later and be infinitely more useful than them. SMG sucks. Pistol's better than the SMG, that's a problem. So we're already, like, barely, like, 30 minutes into the game, and they've already, you know, said, ah, matches aren't interesting enough, let's have human versus human. Where'd that zipline come from? It just sort of came into being.
Alright, spread out! Find Deckard! Shoot to kill!
There's some popping in that audio. Majority of this game's voice acting was recorded inside of a tin can. You'll notice, if you perk your ears and listen closely, you'll notice that a lot of the voice acting in this game has really poor audio quality, so get used to that nice and early, because it's not going to get any better. AI. Not the brightest. They sort of just stand there and wait for you to shoot them to death. Oh.
Deckard, if you come across those soldiers, you've probably figured out they're not government. They're LaFay's private security force. He wants us both dead, and I don't know why. I'm heading towards Times Square. Meet me there, and hurry!
Looks like it's about time to book it. Oh, but where will we go? What will we do? Oh, hey, maybe this guy can help us out. Hey, do you know where we can go? You have any ideas? We're up? I don't really see what's up there. I guess there's like that energy beam. Yeah, I noticed that before. I don't know what's up with that, but
hey, buddy, over here.
Oh, what do you want? What do you want, man? Yeah, I'll wave to you too. Hi, how you doing? Like, are you gonna help me out or what? I'm right here. You don't need to.
Get in here fast.
Oh, you want me to? Oh, I don't know why. Like, okay, you want me to come in? Obviously, why? That's what the hand motion was all about. I wasn't sure what it was about before. But
fire things in here. They don't like water much. Do you have any idea what's going on? Thought it was some kind of attack at first, but then those monsters showed up. Starting to think maybe it's the end of the world, you know? Feel like I should have gone to church more often. I don't know about you, but I just want to go home if it's still there.
Well, I can already tell this guy's going to be a long-running companion. That he'll obviously survive this level, and hopefully he'll make it back home and you know, hug his wife and kiss his daughter on the mouth. And, oh, no, I guess he's just there to die. open that door for us and die. Great. Nice knowing you, buddy. Gonna bait you over here, you fucking werewolf thing. So obviously he's dead right now. We can turn our backs to that and just explore a bit. And oh, except that that's their gimmick, is that you have to shoot their heads off, otherwise they don't die. Which is fair enough, because, you know, with my elite FPS skills, I always aim for the head as it is, so this shouldn't be much of a change of pace for me. They do like to toss objects at you, and conveniently there's just tons of objects lying around in this room, just loose objects for them to toss at us. How convenient. Puzzle solved, bitch! Yep, he's dead. That was me venting my frustration at him being dead. Deckard's gotta express his grief too, somehow. Okay, so we need to get up to that ladder. Deckard is too stupid to know to put his gun away, to, you know, free up his hands. So we can't climb the box. So you may be wondering, how could we possibly get up there then? Does this pulley and lever system have anything to do with it? I don't know, how could we possibly interact? You shoot these things, you shoot these stupid fucking things, and they explode with really shitty looking water, and it sends this thing going upwards. Bam. I done did it. Half-Life 2 ain't got nothing on me. Let's get some more pistol ammo, that's what I'm looking for right now. Convenient that it's just lying around. Convenient that there's 89 bullets inside of that pistol. It's this lone singular pistol, because I don't see any clips or anything. Okay, but amazingly, still gotta... There's like, it's very specific about where you can jump. It's hard to explain, but this basically the geometry in this game is not ideal, is what I'm getting at. That the platforming sucks. That it is infinitely more frustrating than it has any right to be. And it is, as such, is a tedious fucking chore. Speaking of platforming, here's an entire fucking room which is dedicated to platforming. Oh, I do not like this room. I do not like this room at all.
This door's locked. I can't open it. There's an override switch in the warehouse foreman's office. You'll have to find a way up there to reach the override switch for this door.
Whatever happened to saying fucking hi to people? I mean, honestly. Okay, ladder here. You'll be able to tell soon enough that I've done this a few times. Oh. Fuck. Hitbox on that is very... Fuck! God damn it. I forgot to get a running start, so... Oh, I'm not equipped for this fight. Now I am. If you don't get a running start, your jump will take you, like, nowhere, so you always have to sprint before you jump, otherwise you'll just fall, like, 2 feet in front of yourself. But of course, if you're sprinting, you run the risk of falling off these stupid fucking platforms, so pick your fucking poison! Alright, here's where the real shit begins. And the entire time we're trying to do this stupid bullshit, we're gonna be attacked by these fucking things. Pretty sure I took his head off on the way down. Okay. Take this up to here. This is going pretty well so far. There have been runs where I've fallen off that fucking thing by this point. I've had to restart this entire section over because there's fall damage, which means you can instantly die if you fall too far, which means that you have to replay from the checkpoint where the cop is ushering you into the door, and I do not want to replay from there. Guess you're fucking dead. Whoever that was on there. Probably a cop. Probably the cop from downstairs who told us about this room. I know better than to jump from here. Guess practice really does make perfect. I guess when you replay a section of the level like 4 or 5 times, I guess you played a little more cautiously, 6 or 7. And just wait for this to take us on its little trip. Good enough. Oh, did I overshoot it a bit? Yeah, fuck, looks like I did. So it's the difference between, like, getting no distance when you jump at all versus launching across the fucking room. This was deliberately modeled to look like that. There's some, even coming up, I think, there's some, like, just modeled corpses in this game that just look very silly, that look just very poorly modeled, and I'm hoping to show another one off in the very near future. Where is that fucking... Oh, I forgot I have the waypoint key. I'm stupid. No, I think I actually have to... Oh, fuck. Luckily, there's a ladder right there. And navigate through this little maze. Convenient that they left these ladders in this warehouse, as opposed to, you know, leaving gaps between the crates and boxes and shit. As opposed to just leaving gaps that people can walk through between the containers, they just put ladders up, because that's just as good, just as safe, right? Just as efficient. Wonderful. It's... Okay. I get that these guys are fucked up. Like, shit is obviously not good. They're dying in very unnatural ways. But really, you're gonna go with, like, that? Like, the little spindly arm effect there? Come on. Faces of death. Nothing doing over here. Gotta collect the PDAs. I mean, God forbid I miss one of those and have to replay the level to get it. Can I just flick the switch? Okay. Now I've gotta shoot the box, gotta move it out of the way. You know, okay, I can get, like, I partially get why these would exist from a gameplay mechanic. In case, like, you know, there's enemies attacking you, that's like an incentive to kill the enemies first. Like that one panel from the werewolf room. That, you know, obviously you want to kill the enemy before you progress. But what are the stakes right now in this room with nothing around us, with no enemies behind, in front, anywhere around us? Why fucking make me wait to open this door? Just think about it. Obviously, nothing bad is gonna happen in this room. Oh my god, this pistol fucking... This SMG fucking sucks, rather. Pistol is fucking fine, I think. Has a tendency to blow off heads without even aiming for the heads sometimes. Gee, I wonder what enemy is on the other side of this fucking door. What a shock. It's almost as if the game is unwilling to throw different kinds of the same, like, different types of enemies at you at the same time. Where they just want to, like, pattern it or, like, theme it. Like, this is the werewolf section! And coming up next, the flame drake section. I guess that's what you get for sitting too close to the screen. Oh, I kill me. Please kill me. Guess we're going back to the subway now. It's just too compelling a theme for like level design to stay away from for too long. Guy's dead. Cool, so we went around that way just so I can open the door. That's I guess that's like realistic, I guess, that you would have to open that door, but fuck, I mean, what's the point? You're just padding out the game at this point. Maybe he's not holding on to his gore. Maybe he's, like, gutting himself, you know, like, ritual suicide, seppuku style, you know? That's a word I know. That's a Japanese word. I'm cultured. Fuckers. Trying to go out the wrong end of the train. I think we're almost done with this godforsaken level. By the way, I should mention that the F key is also the reload key, which is why you saw me reload right there when I meant to open up the door. And obviously you can't, you're using both hands to reload, so you can't activate that door panel while you're reloading. So if you accidentally, aren't close enough to a panel when you try to open it, you have to sit through your reload animation. Which doesn't seem like that big a deal, but if you're using like some of the later weapons which have longer reload times, then it's a big fucking deal, because then you're just stuck waiting. And that sucks. And yes, these guys are baddies. In more ways than one, scrub shits. So we're gonna be fighting a few of them right now. In addition to flame drakes. Ooh, they're really mixing things up. So, there's a sort of semi-interesting dilemma here, which is, do you let the monsters kill the bad guys with guns for you? Or do you, you know, you turn out the water, have to deal with the guys with guns yourself, but not have to deal with the infinitely respawning monsters? And it's not really that big a dilemma, because both of them are so easy to kill, and both of them are so insignificant in the grand scheme of things, such minor threats that... Oh, hold on. Totally worth it. Did I say worth it? I meant worthless. My bad, I always say that wrong. It always comes out wrong. I still took damage from that a bit, despite turning it off, so that's always great. Nope. I should probably take a bit of cover. Probably switch to my better weapon. Probably heal up while I'm at it.
Deckard, LeFay soldiers are setting up command posts all over the city. I found an unguarded post in a subway station near Times Square. Meet me there. I'll use the post to call for help.
So my guess is we probably don't want to step in this water. But what does that leave us to do? How could we possibly... We shoot this vent out. And we turn off the fucking electricity. You probably figured that out. You haven't even played this game yet, presumably. Unless you have, in which case, man, I feel fucking sorry for you. You'll notice I didn't use the Molotov cocktails before when we first got them. That's because I rarely fucking use them. Where's the electricity shutoff thing again? It should be... it should be in this room. That's right. They don't show that in the waypoint for whatever reason. The waypoint is still past the water as opposed to the switch you need to flip. And now this water is perfectly safe and has no charge left in it. No danger of being electrocuted after we turned off electricity, right? Because water can't retain. Probably should have hit the brakes a bit sooner on that. This is just lying around. I guess it maybe got flung from the car as it was crashing. Oh, I see. I'm stupid. I forgot I had, no health, and I tried to do a melee kill. That was completely my fault. Shit. Well, there's your first death. Better to get out of the way earlier rather than later, I guess. Wait, no, it's actually worse, because then I look like a scrub. Whereas if I die later, I have an excuse. Shit. I suck. How far back are they gonna checkpoint me? Okay, fuckers. Let's knock this shit out real quick, like.
Subway station near Times Square. Meet me there. I'll use the post to call for help.
Okay, this time use the pistol, maybe even the SMG. No need to get up close and personal, as they say. Wait for that animation to finish. Wait for that one too. Waste my entire clip because they're still in their invulnerable animations. Great. And just one more of these for good measure, because why not, right? Are you... Oh, for fuck's sake. And, no, one more for good measure. Get double your money's worth.
Deckard, thank God you made it. Follow me and I'll get us out of the city. The soldiers guarding this post were called away a little while ago. Something big is happening in Times Square.
Ooh. Want me to... Where should I go? You aren't... Look, we just talked. Where do you want me to go? I got this. Like, it's motion in like a direction or something. Oh Jesus, I'll go. I mean, where are you looking at? Hello, are you? I'm next to my contact lady. Are you staring at my dick? You're looking directly at my package. Oh, you little minx. Well, alright then, close the door behind us. Let's get down to it. Let's get down to business, why don't we? The business of lovemaking.
This isn't what LeFay said was going to happen today. I had no idea those creatures were going to be released, or that he'd try to kill both of us. Luckily, I know some people who can help us stop him. Sort of an enemy of my enemy relationship, if you understand my meaning.
No, me Deckard, me no understand.
Vivian, I thought those access codes looked familiar, and you have Deckard at your side. It seems you two have a greater aptitude for survival than I anticipated.
LeFay, you bastard! You set us up to open the box. Why?
My dear, if I didn't let you in on the details of my operation when I hired Mr. Deckard, what makes you think I'm going to do so now? Frankly, you were always too ambitious to be trusted.
Why kill us, then?
Deckard, I want dead for very specific reasons. And while you don't know my full plans for Pandora's Box, Vivian, you know enough to be inconvenient. So farewell, my dear, and goodbye, Mr. Deckard. I'm sure you're professional enough to understand. It's just business.
Damn him! He distracted us and sent troops to finish us off.
Well, I guess that music is my cue to go kick some ass, then. My gun didn't fire for a second there. That's a fucking problem in the middle of the firefights. Yeah, there's some dudes. What the hell are you talking about, lady? Aw, oh, man, the music stopped. Done? Everything looks clear to me. Oh! Vivian, we're okay. Everything's alright. You can wipe that sour look off your face, why don't you? See, we're okay. What are you shooting at? Are you shooting at this guy? He's on our team. You see, the crosshair's green. So just don't shoot. Now you're shooting at me, you fuck.
Deckard!
Jesus Christ.
Area secure. What do we do with Deckard and Vivian? Copy that.
You know, on second thought, Vivian, maybe you did have the right idea shooting these assholes.
Afternoon, Miss Kane. Lovely to see you again. Now, could you please tell me exactly why I shouldn't shoot you and your companion right here, right now?
Well, if that isn't one of the worst voice acting performances in video game history, it's definitely up there in the top 10. Oh, God, that's a fucking level. That's a recording. Well, I'm gonna leave it on that little cliffhanger, because that's actually where the game would launch into a second cutscene. But I've had enough of this game for one sitting. You can join me next time for episode... I was going to say episode 2, but this is episode 2. I'm splitting this first level into two episodes. You'll see me in the next video I post. How's that? Is that good? Good.